a lot of brain cells, huh, to really think of medical topics. And hands down to Dr. Adam to really discuss about medical topics in his YouTubes. And ang dami din niyang videos, di ba? Wanda V. Miranda, and welcome back to my YouTube channel, Dr. Vlogger. So for this video, actually I was contemplating kung gagawin ko ba tong video na to, kasi the past few days there's this certain issue regarding yun sa latest video ni Doc Adam. I may not know him personally, so I admit I am a new subscriber of him. The topic has been such a big issue, especially when you are a YouTuber and you are a doctor. Nakikita ko siya sa feed ko sa YouTube. I already finished my residency training in internal medicine. It is a specialization already, along with surgery, my OB, pediat, and there's the internal medicine. We deal with adult diseases, conditions, hypertension, diabetes, and even cancer sometimes. And then we refer them to the subspecialist, oncologist, cardiologist, nephrologist. Hindi naman to reaction video regarding the whole video of Doc Adam. Regarding lang the topic as a whole, yun na nga, parang nababother kasi yung doctor instincts ko regarding that one. Konti lang naman din pa kaming YouTubers that are doctors, and I feel it is one of our obligations to enlighten and to impart, to share some information to our subscribers regarding what is happening. When I became a subscriber of Doc Adam, to tell you honestly, I've been impressed by what he's doing and what he did. And only few doctors, konti lang yung mga doctors actually na kaya yung ginagawa niya. He verbally expressed, and he also bravely corrected, you know, yung mga misleading information or yung mga hindi tamang medical advices na ibang mga tao. I mean, I'm not going to talk about each and every one of them, of course, or yung latest ba na issue ni Doc Adam. But I am with him in that. I agree with some of the things that he said. Kasi hindi ko naman napanood lahat ng mga videos pa niya, like what I've said, new subscriber lang po ako. So far, yung mga napapanood ko, I agree with his corrections. And regarding naman his latest issue, I hope he gets through this and talagang naninindigan si Doc Adam, and he has a point. He's courageous enough to say na, you know, bring it on, kasi meron naman din siyang medical documents to prove that he is right. And pag right ka naman talaga, di ba, you okay lang sa'yo yung laban, because you know at the end you will win. Regarding naman this herbal medicine, this alternative medicine, what I do know right now, may 10 herbal medicines that are backed up or validated with medical clinical trials. Lahat naman na ibibigay na gamot ng isang doktor underwent medical trials or clinical trials. Talagang tinitest sila, pinag-aaralan ng, it will take years, just like when you make the vaccines. DOH only approved of 10 herbal medicines. Yun ang alam ko, ha, like, mayroon naman doon garlic, napaka-anti-cholesterol, and etc. I'm not going to talk about each one of them. What I'm going to say now, sana kung alam mong you're promoting or you're endorsing or you're giving out these herbal medicines that are beneficial, then huwag kayong ma-offend, di ba? Kung if you're watching this, and perhaps you're not watching this, if your products are, di ba, parang may medical trials, meron ka namang proof and documents na makapagsasabi na they really are therapeutic, hindi ko dapat ma-offend with my opinion about this. But if, contrary to what I said earlier, kung hindi din, kung alam mo, in your conscience, alam mo na hindi siya backed up with science, hindi siya evidence-based, yung herbal medicines that you promote, well, this is for you. Because as an internist, bagsakan talaga kami ng mga, what will I say, how will I say this, ng mga patients na lumala or perhaps nasa end stage na ng renal failure nila, because nalalaman namin that this patient took like 1 year, 2 years of this kind of herbal medicines or this alternative medicines, hindi sila pumunta muna sa doktor regarding their condition, or kung pumunta man sila, na-diagnose lang sila, and then after that, they resulted to, you know, seeking advice sa herbal, sa alternative. I have nothing against that naman. It's the decision of the patient, the decision of the person that has the disease. Pag pumunta na kasi sila sa amin, gumagrabe na. So totoo lang, it's still our duty to heal them or to perhaps offer the best treatment that is pwede para sa kanila pag pumunta na sila sa amin. But what I really want to say is the time that person or that patient, I'm not saying na sa herbal medicine namatay or whatever, but yung time na yon na he spent taking that medicine, seeking out alternative medicine, or kung, you know, hindi sila napumunta talaga sa mga specialista, sayang kasi. And especially if you have cancer, we know that time is of the essence in that disease. Nawala siya, naglaho na yung time na yun, na pwede naman if ever lang, especially, treatable pala siya, manageable. I mean, cancer, there are stages, there are prognosis, may mga nag-good prognosis, bad prognosis, you'll never know, good prognosis pala yun. And if you sought consult, dun pa lang, diagnose ka, baka na-treat na natin yan. Pero kung pupunta kayo, nasa end stage na, nag-mets na, metastasis na, and sadly, di ba, kahit i-offer pa namin yung best treatment, during that stage, during that time, it's really too late already. It's always their decision. We will respect that. But I want to tell my subscribers, the patients, to really do research more about what you are trying to avail, about those videos that you see in the internet, and if backed up by science. I mean, kami, like ako, nag-aral ako pre-med, medicine, nag-residency training pa ako ng 3 years, it's a specialization already. We are trained to be evidence-based, and it works kasi, medications works, and chemotherapeutic agents works, of course, not all the time, but they work, because through the years, talagang pinag-aralan sila eh. Hindi naman kasi lahat pare-pareho ang mga pasyente. Pinag-aaralan namin yan by patient and holistically. We check the chorea, we check the kidney function, the heart function, kung kaya ba ng lungs niya, kung ano yung mga comorbids niya. History and physical examination is always important. I'm not like declaring na herbal medicines pinapaglalaan niya isang sakit, ganun. Hindi naman, because of course herbal medicines, especially kung wala kong sakit, they help naman ah, because diba, it's herbal, and especially if talagang organic talaga siya, diba? I mean, I'm not a specialist regarding that one. I've even read a few years back, si Juan Polavier pa yun eh, na parang sinasabi nga niya na they're more of a preventive medicine rather than a cure. We as doctors, especially those that decide to do YouTube, we want to share what we know and the right information. Like ako, it is one of my goals to really share what I know, especially during this pandemic. Kumikita siya, fine, nag-trending siya, okay, but he's also a doctor. Sabi nga niya, mas malaki pa nga yung kinikita niya daw sa doctor than rather than being a YouTuber, but he really wants to teach people and to share his knowledge. And personally, ako din, that is one of my goal. And some of my videos nga, boring na kung boring, kasi nga, I really talk about medical topics. Ayoko din naman na magpaka-controversial or whatever. Pero with my, you know, sincerity, yun lang naman yung gusto ko. To share information, medical information to people, to my subscribers, especially those that really subscribe because they like my content. There! Ginawan ko talaga ng video kasi parang deep inside, parang ha, I really want to share. And I also want to react regarding that topic kasi the past few days, yan talaga yung laman ng feed ko. Kasi nga, you know, konti lang naman na doctor. Konti lang kaming doctors na YouTubers, I believe so. I don't know if my internist din na YouTuber. Basta ko, I'm an internist. That's it. That's it, guys. That's all I really want to say. I want to share my piece regarding this matter. Because I'm a doctor, that is a YouTuber, and I feel that it's also one of my responsibility to enlighten and to also inform my subscribers. And don't forget to like my video, share my video, and subscribe to my channel, and click on that notification bell to be updated with the latest uploads. And bye bye, see you in my next video.